I just want to thank everybody for coming, and I hope that you've really taken a lot from taking these photographs. For me, it's a question for me I'd like to actually pose is what the photographs say to you. But I'll give a sort of a brief kind of explanation on what why I actually took these photographs and how and why, you know, and what they actually are meant to portray. And I've called it another day, so it's another day of occupation. When you take a look, each photograph is symbolic to the, say you have images of that kind of show the restrictions that the Palestinians have, like every day where you know, not day passes where they have like you know, there's the freedom of movement. They don't have that. They don't have freedom of movement. And the photographs are supposed to, in a way, connect to that as well, where you see kind of you have like the walls, the doors, a kind of claustrophobic feel to them. This is meant to be so that you can relate to how a Palestinian feels every day, like, and that for me, really, I wanted to capture. I've used sort of bright colours. I've made it bright in a way, because in a way, people. What was most, what really I learned from when I went there, was that how everything is so normalised when it really isn't a normal situation. A refugee camp looks like a village. So when you look at the picture, you could think it's a tourist. Maybe it could be, but actually the living conditions is not as far from the reality, the struggles that they go through. If you actually the truth are under obviously the Israeli the laws. Something that people can look at, they're not war images like you might usually find about when people think about conflict. I mean, the situation, it's not really a conflict, it's an occupation. And I wanted to really emphasize on that, that there's too much talk, there's too much showing that it's a war, you know, and that they're oppressed, and people are oppressed. But we must know that these photographs are also meant to express the signs of hope too, that when I was there and I was interacting with the children, they knew I was taking photographs, so they would run and they would bring their flags, and they would, you know, they wanted to just show that, you know, we're here, we have a right to the freedoms of other children, yet they would clearly, you know, that there's also a state where they're resisting, but it's so, they're just children and they want to play. And I've captured some images where you think, you know, they're playing in rubble, there's barbed wire, it's a park, but this is the conditions that they're living under. And we mustn't, for me, I don't want, you know, we all have an obligation to kind of make sure that Palestine is not forgotten, and it's everybody's obligation. And really that's my message for, what you know, with another day. It's more meant to draw you in, hopefully, kind of people can then relate and connect with the photographs, with the emotions, with the of the Palestinian people. And not everyone may, inshallah, everyone does have this opportunity to go and actually experience, because it is different to when you're looking at the media, you're watching the media, you're making your mind, you're being influenced by the media as such. It could be negative, it could be positive, it's kind of a part of the story, but it could be, I wanted to tell my sort of what I understood when I went there. And another day, I want to sort of bring back kind of an insight, really in an abstract way, kind of to show how you have like this photograph here where you've got the Zionist Jew. He's very clear that you can't see him. And then you have like the sort of Palestinians coming, you can see them. But the thing is, it's symbolic to how they're actually living under this kind of hostility. There's definitely a feeling of that any moment now something is going to happen, and it's not, if you don't feel safe, that's what I can say. It isn't a, you know, an environment that you feel safe at all. And you can see that that's what the children feel, that's what, you know, the older generation, they continue, you know, they've lived through it. But yeah, there's a strength in their faces, like there is a hope, there is a form, and I think the pictures will speak for itself. I hope that that's what I would like to hear your views, actually. Anyone could you give me any kind of what the photographs actually say to you?
I just want to know, like, how many pictures did you choose from, and when you were choosing which ones you were going to actually show, was there a certain theme or like the logical manner you chose?
Yes, I probably took like thousands of pictures, but the way I have selected them, because there is you know, the photographs, they may be shot slightly different, and some are like, there's more like shadows and different, some are more bright and more, there's certainly a different, but they're definitely, I've chosen deliberately to, I thought that they do work together quite well, although each one has a different story, but they're all part of one, another bit. It's about that, and I think you know that you see all the different kinds of flags as well. So you've got like you know, and there's a lot of contrast as well with the colours, but it's very symbolic for me, and I just wanted to choose the best really for the rest of the film to all work together. And I hope that they do compliment on the other one, even though they're quite. Like for example, the Dome of the Rock, and then below it you see this wall. But if you look at that on its own, you think that's just a nice, you know, build. But actually, everything is about there needs to be Palestine. We want a free Palestine, and so that's the root to really my whole intentions, really, of why I've chosen these different images. Put them together because I think that they actually do, although they look like they contradict, but actually this is all part of Palestinian life. It is very, there is no balance actually within, so in a way, maybe that's how, you know, if you're looking at the pictures, you might be sort of questioning that. Why would you have an image that might be more beautiful, one that's kind of very, you know, it's just a wall. But yes, it's all meant to be kind of message behind it. Thank you.
Is this your first physical exhibition? And did you, when you were taking these pictures, did you have an exhibition in mind?
Yeah, I didn't have an exhibition in mind originally, but I definitely, when I was there, I was thinking about capturing the lives of ordinary Palestinians. You know, just sort of, I was observing. I have had another exhibition. It was on Iran, so I've taken photographs in Iran. And again, really more so the cultural side of things as well. So,
It was your first trip to Palestine?
Yes. Fortunate enough to go with an official delegation, so if I had longer time, I think it was so much. But I was literally just, it was really just on the move all the time because I was following this delegation, so I was fortunate just to capture what I could, really. Yes.
So, this is the first time we've been to Palestine. What was the thing that you knew the most?
There is a sense of fear that, you know, anything could happen really, because you've got a camera, so it's almost like a weapon, you know. And there is that risk factor of any moment your camera could be like confiscated or whatever. But I actually did, so I was coming, we were coming through a checkpoint, and that for me was quite really kind of an experience that it was so dehumanising. And I was thinking, you know, how can people, these Palestinians have to go through this every day just to, so I think it's a serious violation that, and it's that they're treated as not even human. And that's, for me, I thought that was really, just to experience that was quite shocking. And another, I was aware of it, but to actually experience it is definitely triggers more kind of, it makes you feel like something has to be done about this. And then another thing that really kind of dawned upon me was the situation of how us, we've come from Britain, so there was a lot of respect because we were actually from the Palestinian authorities, because we were from England, they were kind of showing us around Jerusalem. And I experienced something that was more painful, I think, because where I'd witnessed how it was actually Palestinian Authority that they made people who were praying in the Al-Aqsa, there was some section that they made people who were praying to move out of the way because we were there as visitors. And that, I was like, no, you don't need to do that, that's disrespectful. But that for me also was a sign of how the occupation has affected the Palestinians in a way that, you know, it's one of those, it's a bit like how colonialism affects us in a way. It was the same, it made me really sad, and that was sort of a breaking point there for me, where I had to apologise to the people, the Palestinian people, for what, because I felt ashamed, really. But I think from an outside, you know, they don't realise it, but they sometimes, you know, there are so many factors involved when you're actually living under occupation that that was one I never expected. But it opened my eyes to another perspective that it's not just the Zionists sometimes, that, you know, you've now got Palestinian Authority too, that kind of, there's a lot of dimensions involved. I love you, you know, it's like they were so kind, respectful. I even remember asking a child, do you want me to get you an ice cream? And he was like, no, thank you, like, it's okay. And they're just so, they have this this dignity that I was so surprised to see how well behaved they were. How, but at the same time, I can see that they've been made to grow up so fast as well. In the sense, they're still children, but they feel like I said, when they would run and get the flags, for example, they knew that I'm capturing them with a camera. So, you know, for them, they want this. I really believe this sense is their way of resistance. It's like we are here. We're not. This, you know, this is our land. They are part of the resistance. They can't be separate from it. And sadly, they are affected, but I can see they were very strong. But at the same time, it seemed like us as adults, and that we need to protect children. And for me, I wanted to specifically show the children and their emotions, so that they will not be, you know, they're not forgotten. We have to do everything we can to protect, and also to, they have a right to a future, freedom of movement, freedom of everything that everyone deserves, is that equality, you know, human rights is the main, you know, we all deserve that in life, and they deserve life.
It was very interesting and very impressive to see. Because I've never been to Palestine myself, so it was very good to see how it's like, how everyday life is for Palestinians. A lot of the pictures were very shocking as well, and others looked just normal when you look at them first, but then when you explained to me the meaning and the life of these persons, they actually meant more, and yeah, they're very interesting.